Okay, it's time to walk you through these very loose and undone casual waves that I've been wearing pretty much daily these days. I usually wash and blow dry my hair at night and then sleep with it in a ponytail on top of my head. But just to show you what I'm starting with, I've got a little tiny bit of bend in the back that will just blend in with the curls, but the rest of my hair is straight. I have enjoyed sectioning off a halo section, and that's it for these curls. So this gives a little bit more dimension and variety to the curls around the crown and back area of the hair, which I think is kind of a good statement part of the hair. Like if the back of your hair looks great, you're crushing it. So go ahead and section off a halo section, and then I'm using a 1.5 inch curling iron. This is, this will give you a curl, but it will pretty likely just sort of fall into a very loose wave within, I'd say, an hour or so after using it, but that's the look I'm going for. As always, that first section should go away from your face, and then this section right behind it is also going away from my face. You can see I'm loading the hair in as close to the root as I can get, and then the curling iron remains in that same spot, and I'm simply twisting and feeding the hair into the iron versus sliding the iron down the hair. That is a big no-no if you want curls and not just bend at the end. So this next section I'm going to is going to be twisted toward my face, as you can see. And you'll follow that same pattern as you work your way around the hair. I'll alternate from curling it toward my face to curling it away from my face until I get to the opposite side. And then I'll curl any hair that I get to on my right side away from my face so the front of my hair looks balanced. So next I'll be working on the halo section. I just let it down, rig my fingers through it, and let the part fall where it will be. And then the curls for this section will all be going away from my face until I get to the very back, and then I'll just kind of switch directions and make sure all the hair on the right side of my head goes to the back. And the reason for this is anytime I have tried to curl a section of hair on the top of my hair toward my face, it gets this weird bend. So I have found that that just works best for me. What I like about that too is these curls that are going away from my face will be sitting on top of curls that were curled toward my face. So that will help even more keep the curls from sort of blending into each other, because it'll be nearly impossible since they've been curled opposite directions. At this point, I gently rake my fingers through the hair. I don't break up the curls as much as I would had I used a smaller barrel iron, because I know these curls will fall out a little bit, but I'm mainly just breaking them up so they don't look like those solid ringlets you saw. So I'll do that on both sides. And I have been loving the Living Proof Dry Volume Blast Volume and Texture Spray. That stuff is crazy awesome. So give it a good shake and then spray it all around the mid shaft to ends of your hair. And then I like to tease a little bit. Use the fine tooth end of the comb. That'll give you a good tease. And here I'm just doing sort of a rough tease. I'm not trying to create a ton of volume. And I'm working on the underneath part of my hair since I don't want a ton of volume at the crown and top. I just want more width in the sides. And then I just use my fingers to soften out any of the teasing that you can see, but I'm still trying to pump it up a little bit, and I'll finish with a spritz of hairspray. And that's it. It'll fall out and relax even a little bit more, which is something I really like, but it's super easy to do and gives you a very casual everyday wave.